Hey everybody, this is Matt.
And I'm Alex.
And if you're watching this video, you've basically gotten a message that talks about unnatural links to your site. And so we wanted to give you a little bit of guidance about what the message means, how to correct the problem, and, you know, to learn a little bit more about it, to give you more context. So if you've gotten this message, it basically means that we have seen enough low quality or spammy links to your site that it's affected our opinion of your entire site. So it is something that's worth taking action on and trying to address. We don't like to take action on sites, you know, we prefer not to, but we have to protect users. Users come first and search quality comes first. And so as a result, when we see a site that might have high quality content, but is doing something like link spam or something like that, we do take action on that. So we have a bunch of algorithms that also operate, of course, but in this particular case, if you're reading this, if you're watching this video or on this particular help page, it means that you probably have gotten a message or you're trying to learn more about this particular message, which means we've taken manual action on your links. Okay, so how do you fix this? Well, step into Google's shoes for just a minute and think about what Google's goals are. We want to protect the user experience. And so we've basically got two things that we look for in a reconsideration request. First, we want to know that the issue has been corrected. We want to know that the link spam has been taken down or made sure that it doesn't pass PageRank. And second, we want some assurance or some idea that it's not going to come up again, that it's not going to be an issue in the future. So to start out with, how do you fix the issue? Alex, do you want to go through a little bit how you would sort of tackle this?
Yeah, sure. So as a webmaster, your primary goal here is to just reach out to sites that you've either explicitly purchased links from or maybe any services that you've used to automatically generate backlinks to your site. When you reach out to these webmasters or these websites, there are a couple of things you can tell them to do. You can either have them remove those links, you can have them use a rel equals no follow attribute to ensure that they no longer pass PageRank, or you can also have them redirect your links through a URL on their site that's blocked by the robots.txt file. And this also ensures that PageRank is no longer passed and Google will no longer consider it when generating their search algorithms.
Mm-hmm. Now, this is a message that you get for just general link spam. So it can be paid links, right? Mm-hmm. In theory, it could be leaving spammy blog comments. It could be, you know, directories where you're paying for it, link exchanges where you've mm-hmm. gone really excessive, article marketing where you've gone too far, you've got way too many keyword-rich anchor text links, all that sort of stuff, right? Basically, if you're getting this message, then we think you've got a lot of spammy or low-quality links that either you did or someone on your behalf basically gathered mm-hmm. for you, right? Yeah. Okay, so basically you want to clean that up as much as possible. So it can be frustrating to try to take links down off the web. I know that can be an effort. At the same time, we want to put people on a level playing field, and so we want sites that rank to rank based on their merit, not based on link spam or something like that. So if you've gotten this message, the first and foremost thing I would do is try to clean up those links as much as possible. You might be able to get, you know, whoever was building the links, if it was an SEO or an agency, to help you. You might have to do it yourself. In theory, you could hire someone else to help you try to get those links down. But you really want to get as much down as possible. Now, it's almost as important to try to help Google understand that you've really sort of tried to correct things. So mm-hmm. so talk a little bit about documentation, you know.
Sure. So great documentation is extremely important for a reconsideration request. It's indicative of the amount of effort that you've put in to clean up your site. And because the purpose of a reconsideration request is to enable or reinstate trust with your site with Google, the more documentation you provide us, it's the easier for us to reconsider and see the progress that you've made on your site.
Yeah, absolutely. So the mental model we want you to have is this. We'd like to see as much of the link spam go away as possible, and so that's your first goal, to try to get as much down. And then we need to know that, ideally, we're not going to see this sort of link spam in the future. And so that's where the documentation comes into effect. You know, whether you're tracking things in a spreadsheet or you're just doing a good job of monitoring, you know, how many sites you've asked to take things down, essentially we just want to know you've done a prolonged, sustained effort to try to clean things up as much as possible. And helping us understand that with a good reconsideration request is, in many cases, as helpful as, you know, it's important to get the links down, but it's also important that we understand that you are trying to get the links down and you're trying not to do link spam in the future. Now, one last resort that you can do, if, you know, imagine you've done, someone on your behalf has done blog spam, like leaving a bunch of spammy blog comments or something like that. That might not be the sort of thing where you can get every single link down. We do encourage you to get as much as possible down off the web, just because you don't want people to jump to conclusions, right? If someone else looks at your backlinks and they look really spammy, they're going to think, oh, this is a bad sign in general. So it's best to get all those links off the web as much as possible. But if you've done all the work that you can, you've written everybody twice, you've contacted as many sites as you can, and there's still a few links that you can't get down, you can use a tool that we've recently released that lets you disavow links. That basically says, okay, Google, I'd like you to ignore certain links to my site. So again, we want you to do the effort to remove as much as possible off the web itself, but there is another tool that you can use to sort of say, okay, we would also like you to disavow or ignore these particular links. And we'll try to make a special dedicated video about that and have its own help page. But I don't want to get into all of that right now. I basically just want to communicate, try to make sure that you get as many of the links down as possible, and then have good documentation to let us know that, yes, okay, we've turned a corner, we're not going to be doing this sort of thing in the future. Anything else we should mention, or we covered the high-order bits?
I think we covered most of it. Again, the purpose of a reconsideration request, especially with links pointing to your site, is to reinstate trust. And the more documentation you provide and the more effort that you put in to clean up your backlinks, that'll help us a lot in that process.
Okay, so if you're watching this video, you probably started very frustrated, perhaps angry, but I hope this gives you at least a little bit of context about what we're looking for so that in an ideal world you can move forward and figure out the best way to sort of solve the situation and be in good shape going forward. So I hope that helps.